Hey everyone, this is Nico Carver. My website is at nebulaphotos.com. We all know that deep sky astrophotography is an expensive hobby, so that's why today I wanted to share with you five things that I use all the time that are each under 10 bucks. First up, we have the LED headlamp. Put it on like this. There's a one button operation, turns on just like that. And you can see that it went right to the red. That's because that this one has a memory, so it always remembers that the last setting you used. That's very important to look for. Sometimes it's hard to find that online because some of them, when you click that button, it always goes to white light first, which you really want to avoid because if you ever go to a star party, visual astronomers are going to be mad at you if you use white light on the field. This can do white light too, though. So if I hold this button for a little while, you can see it goes from red into white. That can be helpful to have the white light too, because a lot of times when I'm finishing up at the end of the night and there's no one else in the field or I'm alone, I like to just use the white light to make sure I haven't left anything behind. To compare it to other red flashlights you can get, I actually started with a handheld red flashlight like this one. The thing I like about it is that it can go lower than that one, lower intensity. And also, you often forget when you're wearing the headlamp that when you're looking at someone else, it blinds them. So that usually isn't a problem since you're directing it. Of course, the thing I don't like about this is you don't get hands-free operation like you get with a headlamp. And a lot of times as an astrophotographer, you really need both hands to do things. So this is good to have, but I don't use it very often actually. Next up, we have 3M dual lock fasteners. These are often sold under different brand names. I've also seen like Scotch Extreme fasteners, but the main thing is these aren't Velcro. I find Velcro sort of annoying because like if you get your clothing close to it, then your clothing sticks to the Velcro. It leaves some little like filaments behind in the Velcro and then it like stops working. So I don't like Velcro. I love this though. It can hold up to 10 pounds. And what I use it for is just putting all my astrophotography stuff together. Since I'm a mobile imager, I like to have my imaging rig all built up and then I can just take it out of its case, put it onto the mount and start imaging. I'll show you what I mean by that. Okay. I've tried to make my imaging rigs somewhat configurable and customizable so that if I wanted to use, for instance, this telescope, but with a different camera, I could switch out the elements here and do that pretty quickly. What I found is that it can be really annoying if you like put together what you think of as like your permanent setup, but then in a couple months you want to change it and you've already like zip tied everything and then it's just really annoying to change everything out. So that's where this 3M dual lock comes in. What I do is on each like control box, I just have 3M dual lock on both the top and the bottom. So you can see it is on my Pegasus power box. It's on the bottom of this thing. And then I can just snap things together very easily and change the order, put different things in different places. And it makes it really easy to customize this for whatever kind of imaging I'm doing. I can switch out to a lens-based system and still just snap everything back together, but still have the convenience of having everything all in one ready to go imaging rig. All right, next up is the plastic bin. You may be thinking, is that too basic? Like people can't figure out that they need a plastic bin, but I want to show you what I do with mine. So mine works both as a storage and a transport container. So one of the things I have found is that if you're a mobile imager, you bring everything in your car, but then when you get to the field, it can take a lot of time just to get everything out of the car to where you're actually going to set up for imaging. And the more trips you have to make, the longer that takes, of course. So I try to get as much stuff into as few containers as possible so I make fewer trips. And so this is really something that holds a lot of different stuff. It's pretty heavy for that reason. First up, I have this. This is a bunch of different backup cables. I am very superstitious, so I have a backup for almost everything, just in case anything goes wrong. It also holds my QHY pole master and just some other various little useful things. I have another big box inside this box that just holds all kinds of various things. My Pegasus Astro Flatmaster, little power thing, all kinds of different power blocks. This one's for a laptop. Backup power distribution block, dew heater thing. So all kinds of different backups again in this box. Usually I have a mouse and a mouse pad because I find trackpads sometimes annoying. This is another battery. Again, this is mostly backup, but if I don't have AC power or some other power source, I like to have a backup battery for things. This could run my mount or laptop or different things. And I also have two laptops in here. This is my main Lenovo ThinkPad laptop, really fast, and a little dinky Celeron Lenovo that I think I got for like $70 as a backup mostly, but also sometimes I do like to do dual imaging rigs, and it's sometimes I use two laptops for that. Okay, point of all of that is that it holds a bunch of stuff, but then the second point is this is a dual function storage bin. So the next thing that I do with it, I set up my table and I flip it up like this, put my laptop inside, and that prevents dew from falling on the laptop's keyboard and screen, messing up your laptop. And it also, I modified it here, so you can see there's a little hole there in the bottom. I run my power cable and USB cable in for the laptop through there. I have them on both sides just in case I need to run something on the other side of the laptop. They do make things like this, but custom made for using laptops outside, like laptop tents. They're usually really overpriced, I find. And this works just as well, even better since I customized it. The last thing I did to customize it, this does make it over $10, but you don't have to do this. I put some fabric on the back here, and what this does, and it's blackout fabric, it's vinyl on the inside. I can, when I'm at a star party, put this over my head and only I see the laptop screen. The light from the laptop screen doesn't spill out and mess up other people's adapted eyes. So it works like that. I also find that in the winter, this provides a little bit of like a shelter or heat. So I wrap it all around myself, and then my breath inside the box and everything, it makes like a nice little warm room of sorts. All right, speaking of warmth, the next thing up here is hand warmers and rubber bands. I'm wondering if anyone has guessed what I'm thinking with this. This is actually not to warm your hands. It is to warm up a glass element on a lens or a guide scope. This is really handy to have in your kit in case ever you have a dew heater controller or dew heater band go bad, then you have a easy backup. I like this much better than like the other thing people often use, which is like a hair dryer, because it just provides this low level of heat to prevent the dew from ever forming, not getting rid of the dew after it's formed. And I've been told that you really don't ever want dew to form on high quality optics. You want to prevent it from ever happening. Of course, it also messes up your pictures if it does happen. The way to prevent dew is just to heat up the glass or mirror element just slightly above the ambient temperature, which this does a good job of. The one thing I don't like about this is that they're one-time use, so they're sort of wasteful. So I don't do it all the time. If you're a serious astrophotographer, I recommend you do get dew heater bands. But in a pinch, these work really well. The other time that I use them often is those occasional trips where I don't want to bring out a full battery system for controlling the dew heater bands. In that case, I'm usually just using like a DSLR or mirrorless camera and a tracker. And then what you do is you just take, you shake up the hand warmer, you take it, you find where the front glass element is in your lens, you take a rubber band, and you just rubber band that to the front of the lens. And I've done this many times, and it always has worked really well. If you're working with something bigger, like a telescope, you might need something, a different strap than a rubber band, and you might also want to use two or three to heat up a bigger piece of glass. Last but not least is the Botanov mask, and this is a focusing aid. I have a whole video about how to use these and how to make them yourself, so I'll put the link in the description. This is 3D printed, and I 3D print these for free at public libraries. I have found that many public libraries offer free 3D printing. You can often do a free print every day or every week. You'll just have to check with their policies. But it's printed in PLA. The most free 3D printers I found do print in PLA. The only danger with that is you don't want to leave it in a hot car because it will warp. Other than that, this works really, really well. The thing that I really like about it is that I don't have to adjust it. I just design these for the optics that I'm using, and I design it so that it fits right onto the dew shield, and then the pattern is then centered, and the pattern is also designed for the exact focal length of that optic. And that makes a big difference in making sure the pattern is nice and clear and easy to understand. So if you're interested in Botanov masks, watch that video. You can often make them for free if you're interested, or if you just want to buy one, I understand you can buy metal ones from China for under $10 on eBay. Just type in Botanov mask on eBay and sort by price, and you can find really cheap ones. Last thing I'll just say about this while we're on the topic of focusing is that I do use automated focusing now, partly because this just takes up more time, and I'm in a place where I don't get a lot of clear nights. So I like automated focusing just to save me a little time rather than having to stop, find a bright star, focus, and then move back. I think automated focusing saves me a few minutes on that process. But automated focusing is expensive. I'd say hundreds of dollars minimum. And this is, again, free or under $10 to print your own or buy a Botanov mask. All right, that's it. Hopefully you enjoyed this quick video on five essentials under $10. If you have some cheap essentials that you use in your deep sky astrophotography, please let us all know in the comments. And if you like what you've seen and you're not subscribed to this channel, please feel free to subscribe, and I'll be releasing a lot of videos in 2020. If you really like this style of video, I would welcome you to join my Patreon, and that's how I'm going to be supported and doing more and more videos, is through Patreon and YouTube ads. So hopefully this will really take off, and I'll be able to release videos more often. Thanks so much for watching, and clear skies to everyone.